Hello? 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 What's up, everybody? What's up, T. Davis? Goose Sports, Neo? How's everybody doing? Battle Angel in the house? Can y'all hear me all right? The music is loud out here. This is gonna get copyrighted like a you know what. I was sitting over there right next to a speaker. I had to move over here. But I'm sitting down here at the pool with Peete Jr., or as Slim Shady calls him, Repeat. So I figured, hey, it's midday show time. Why not do a midday show? But yeah, I just uploaded the video about the rumors about Clemson going to the Big Ten. And that's all they are right now is rumors. But some of the people that are saying it are people that are somewhat in the know in the football program. And the rumors is not just about Clemson. It's about, what's Nightbot saying? I don't know what Nightbot's talking about. The rumors are not just about Clemson. They're about Florida State, Clemson, Oregon, and Washington. That's what I'm hearing. Ohio State versus Clemson every year. Now, look, the Big Ten's getting rid of divisions the same way that the ACC is. Starting next year. So they wouldn't necessarily play them every year. But even if they played them every 2 or 3 years, Clemson's never played Michigan before in history. That would be interesting. Well, if you can even barely hear it at all, YouTube will hear it. They'll pick it up. Whatever, I don't care. There's nowhere around here I can really stream from in the shade, other than here where the music's playing. So, yeah, hey, Golden Blue Dude, man, rest in peace, brother. Golden Blue Dude was right. man. Listen, if they do announce that Clemson is leaving the ACC and going anywhere other than the ACC, I mean, I'd prefer the SEC or the Big Ten, but if they announce they're going anywhere, there is a party at my house and you're all invited. You're all invited. You just have to drive to Charleston or Somerville. I hope the rumors are true, man. Well, I'm not playing. Alakazam said he'd rather be in the Big Ten. Well, financially, both of them make sense to me. I'm not gonna complain. But it's like I said in my video that I just uploaded. If you're one of these people that likes to go to all the away games and stuff, you know, traveling to Washington or Oregon is just not happening for me. It's not. You know, it's one thing to travel to NC State or Florida State or even Miami or Georgia Tech. It's a whole different thing to fly 2,000 miles to Oregon or Washington. I mean, tickets are ridiculously expensive by themselves, but you add a plane ticket in that and a hotel and all that. Yeah, I can't afford that. Now, would I make an exception to potentially travel up to Ohio to go to the Shoe and watch a game? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, I would. What's up, buddy? You done swimming already? Huh? What do you mean you're bored? There's other kids in there. These kids. I got two kids here. One of them is up in the room, won't come out. We drove 8 hours down here. He won't leave the room. And the other one here, he swims for 5 minutes and he says he's bored. Look, if my parents would have brought me here whenever I was a kid, shit, you wouldn't have seen me. The only time I would go back in the room is to eat. That's it. What? Well, you can either sit here with me or you can swim. We're not going back to the room right now. We didn't come down here to sit in a hotel room. I swear. As soon as Mrs. Peete gives me relief duty with the kids, I'm gonna head right down to that. There's a tiki bar right over here. That's where I'll be at. We're here till Thursday or I think Thursday. And then on Friday we go down to the Keys. And by the way, on the way to the Keys, we have to travel through Miami. Miami is only about 30 minutes from here, I think. And hopefully my plan is to stop at Hard Rock Stadium. And I'll shoot a video from there. I got a few videos planned for this trip. I'm gonna do a Florida Man video, which is easy here. Jesus Christ. How come such a beautiful state has the ugliest people in it? Now, I haven't been to Miami yet. I'm sure there's probably a bunch of beautiful people down there. But people make fun of people from the South, like Tennessee, South Carolina, Georgia. They got nothing on these hilljacks. Yeah, bath salts. I've already been perturbed. I've only been here not even 24 hours. I've already been perturbed twice. First of all, the place we're staying is a timeshare, right? It's not ours. We're staying here for free. That's the reason we came. It's Mrs. Peete's mom's. She got looped into one of those timeshares about 20 years ago, and she still is stuck in it. Anyway, so she gave us the timeshare. We're using it. But anyway, so we check in the hotel yesterday. We get here. I drive 8 hours. We get here around like 6 o'clock in the evening. We check in. I'm tired. I'm hungry. I hadn't eaten all day. I've been in the car with kids all day. So we check in. That process takes 20 freaking minutes for some reason. Then instead of, normally when you check into a hotel, they just give you your room key and they send you on your way, right? No, not here. So they check in and they go, okay, now you got to go over there to the concierge desk and get your wristband. The wristband is like how you get access to the pool and how it'll let you in your room and it does everything, right? You got to go over there to get your wristband. I already knew something was up then. I already knew. So we go over to the concierge desk and they get our names. Where are you from? What are you doing here? Yeah, the reading us the riot act, right? I just want to go up to the room. Right? I just want to get the luggage, go up to the room so I can go get something to eat. And what do you think they do? Well, they try to give us the timeshare deal, right? Well, we can give you some gifts, right? They want to give us gifts. I'm like, I don't want a gift. Well, we give you a $150 voucher to do this. We'll give you a $150 voucher to do that. We'll pay for you to do this. You can have a free dinner across the street, blah, 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 blah. Free jet ski rental, whatever it is. I don't want any of that. All you got to do is come up here tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. for an hour and listen to the timeshare deal. I'm not interested in that. I must have told that lady 50 times I'm not interested in that. So she's like, well, I'm going to give you the free gift anyway. So she gives us, I don't even know what she gave us, a free boat ride or something worth $150. And so Mrs. Peete's like, so we can use this free boat ride? She goes, no, you have to, in order to use the free boat ride, you have to go listen to the thing. And I'm like, I'm not listening to the thing. I don't know how many times I got to tell you, I'm not listening to the thing. Not doing it. Clemson's about to be permanently Ohio State's new dad. 20 minutes. I had to tell her no for 20 minutes. So this morning, so the place we're staying in, it's like a suite, right? It's got like a full kitchen, a living room, a bedroom. It's like an apartment. Pretty nice, actually. The room's actually pretty nice. So this morning, since we're going to be here all week, I'm like, I'm going to go to Publix. There's a Publix like a mile away. And get some groceries for the week, right? Get some drinks, get some snacks and all that shit. So I get in the car, groceries in the car. We pull up, there's a, you have to park in a parking garage here. And to get in the parking garage, there's a code that you have to enter, right? So they give you a code whenever you check in. So I put code in, doesn't work. I put the code in again, doesn't work. So then what do I have to do? Now I have to go to, park the car outside of the parking garage and walk into the front desk and be like, my code doesn't work. She goes, oh, well, we changed the code at the end of the month. She says, okay, so we changed the code at the end of the month. I just checked in 12 hours ago and you already changed the code? How about just give me the new code when I check in? Now I'm getting mad. Don't get me mad on vacation. What's up? You're just gonna have to wait. Why don't you go swim? That's what we came down here for. This kid's just sitting here looking at me. Anyway, where were we? Oh yeah, Clemson to the Big Ten. I really hope that happens. And then they give you a card. Where is it at? Right here. Instead of just having like a towel station, you have to have a card to get a towel. Now I gotta go through a bunch of rigmarole and show this stupid ass card to get a towel for the pool.
Are y'all using one of the extra seats?
No, you can take it.
You sure?
Yeah.
I just need one.
Yeah, go ahead.
Thank you, man. Uh-huh.
The AC, hold on, what did he just say? Yeah, they're tracking my every move. It's like the CIA around here. The ACC is like watching a person growing up that's crying for help and doesn't want a life preserver, like watching a slow death. Yeah, exactly, slow death. But I'm interested to see if they do say that they're leaving, how are they gonna do that? And also, not only that, when? That's the real key here. Because if they come out and say Clemson and Florida State are leaving the ACC to go to the Big Ten or wherever, I want to know when. Because there's a big difference between 2024 and 2034. Like, it would be stupid to say we're leaving and going to the Big Ten in 2034, 10 years from now. Because I ain't got no interest in it. Hell, I might not even be alive 10 years from now. Yeah, it would make more sense to go to the SEC. And, I mean, Clemson already has some built-in old rivalries and some kind of new rivalries with Alabama, if you throw Alabama in there. Obviously, Georgia. So, but just getting out of the ACC is a win. It doesn't really matter where they go. But somebody said something about Gold and Blue Dude earlier. It is a win in Gold and Blue Dude's column if that happens. And he spent a lot of time talking about conference realignment, but he also talked about the fact that we're moving into super conferences. And if the Big Ten acquires four more teams, like the rumor is, and the SEC gets a couple more teams, and we already know what's going on with the Big 12, they're swallowing up teams left and right. Then you might not have two super conferences, but you definitely have three. Which I'm not sure how I feel about that. I don't know if that's good for the sport or not. But it is what it is, you know. And by the way, if you did end up seeing three super conferences, you would see an expansion of the playoff past 12, probably. To 16 or even 24, it would basically be an NFL-style schedule and playoff system. That's what it would be. What's up, buddy? Where do you want to go? You want to go sit in the room? No, I'm not going to the room. I don't know what's wrong with these kids. Want to drive 8 hours to South Florida and sit in a hotel room? Not happening. Everybody that walks by is looking at me like, what is this guy doing? You know? They just want to play on their devices. Yeah, well, sorry. Uncle Lou says no one's leaving the ACC. I didn't say they were. I said that's the rumor. And I hope the rumor's true. That's all. What's up, Zona Man? We already know Florida State wants out. Florida State and Clemson to the Big Ten would be silly. Well, Florida State and Clemson in the ACC is silly at this point. I mean, with what's going on in these other conferences, the ACC is about to fall way behind. And I don't know about you, but I'd rather take my chances and jump off that ship and swim in a shark-infested water than just go down with the ship. This ain't the Titanic, and I'm not the captain. You know what I mean? No, I'm not dancing. Have you seen me dance? Forget two left feet. I don't even have... when I dance, I don't even have 2 feet. I'm like BVD. I'm hopping around on one leg and doing the sprinkler. You know what I mean? The sprinkler deal. That's about all I can do. I got two moves. The sprinkler and the MC Hammer. That's it. I don't dance. I don't dance. I don't dance. I don't sing. I have no talent. I'm talentless. Would South Carolina try to block Clemson going to the SEC? Probably they would. Yeah. I'm pretty sure that they did back in when was that? The early 90s? I don't remember. I have a bad memory. I'm pretty sure that there was rumors about Clemson and Florida State going to the SEC back in the 90s. And I'm pretty sure South Carolina voted against Clemson. Why wouldn't they? It's bad enough losing to them at 7 out of 8 years throughout history. Imagine if they lost to them in their own conference. Is the casino closed? No, the casino is only about 3 miles from here, though. There's actually two casinos here. There's a Harrah's, and there's a Hard Rock. I don't know. I'll probably we might go to the casino tomorrow for I don't know. For maybe like a couple hours. What city is this? This is Pompano Beach. It's about 30 miles north of Miami. Doesn't it say Pompano Beach in the title? No, we're not going back to the hotel room. Stop asking. I'm like Nick Saban, Daddy. I'm not doing it, so stop asking. You can either sit here with that ugly mug look on your face, or you can go swim and have a good time. He's just sitting here looking all sad and shit. There's three pools here. There's a pool there, there's a pool there, and there's a pool over there. And he wants to sit here and look sad with me. Well, What was that? No, that's Pompeii. Tiger baskets. That's Pompeii, bro. You been to the Hard Rock? The Hard Rock is a cool casino, but I'm a member of Harrah's, so if I'm going to go anywhere, I'm going to go there to get my points. You know what I mean? Yeah, Mrs. Peete told me that I finally fit in with my Hawaiian shirts. Now I'm finally in a place where I can wear my Hawaiian shirt without getting made fun of. I'm an island boy. Just trying to make it. FSU Twitter lawyers say they're leaving on August 15th. Yeah. I don't know how everybody keeps talking about Clemson and Florida State leaving the ACC. No one's explained to me quite yet how they're going to do that financially, though. Like, how are you going to get out of the grant of rights deal? Nobody can tell me that. Unless they're going to work and try to get out of that, which is possible, but not easy. Oh, they cracked the Da Vinci Code, right? Well, that's what it would have to be. It would have to be their money, and whatever conference takes them would have to also pitch in to buy them out. I mean, I don't see any other way. Either that or take them to court, like I said. It's not out of the realm of possibility to get out of a grant of rights in court. There's no such thing as an ironclad. I keep hearing people say, I've read it. First of all, no, you haven't. Stop telling me you've read it. And you're not a lawyer. Any contract can be gotten out of. Anyone. If it's done right. Yes, you can. Well, you can. Yes, you can. You can dissolve the ACC. I don't know if you can vote yourself out of the grant of rights. That's a different thing. All the grant of rights means is that if anybody leaves and buys their way out, that the ACC still has the rights to the revenue, their TV revenue, no matter where they go. I don't give a shit if Edward's streaming or not. I honestly don't even think about that anymore. Hey, listen, if you're trying to plan your streams around other people, you may as well just quit YouTube altogether. Honestly. I mean, there's 18,000 streams a day. But I will say this. I was actually on Traveling Fools show last night doing the trivia, which was a whole bunch of fun. I didn't even realize Edward was on. I was on Traveling Fools playing trivia. I did go back and watch it, though, after I was off of Traveling Fools stream. And that might be the best stream that Edward's ever done. No. Will Clemson beat Notre Dame? Yes. They will. And God willing, I'll be there. What is it, November the 4th? I think it's November the 4th. I try to go to one game every year. That's the game I'm planning on going to. Me and Mrs. P. Am I going to the Duke game? No. Why would I? Nobody's ever said I can't wait to go see a game at Duke, including me. I mean, unless it's a basketball game. I will be streaming the Duke game, though. So tune into the Pigskin Peete YouTube channel to watch the Duke game in week one, Monday night. What's up, Chunky D33? Baylor Man says he was just on Duke's campus for what? Any week zero stream? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, by the way, here's the thing, though. The week zero stream might end up being a members-only stream. You know, kick off the season with a members-only stream with your boy, Pigskin Pete. It's very easy to become a member. It's only like $3 a month or something. Less than a pack of cigarettes. Twitter lawyers. You want my It's funny because I wasn't planning on doing a midday show today, right? But nobody took my slot. My slot was wide open. It was a gaping slot. Nobody took it. So I had to come in and fill my own slot, which is hard to do. Pretty hard to fill your own slot. Yeah, I have a pretty tight slot. Not even Mike Saha is streaming right now? Now that can't be true. He must be on lunch break. What's wrong, buddy? Why? I must admit, I'm not subscribed to Mike Saha. So I've never seen one of his live streams before. The only time I've ever seen him is on Edward's channel. But we are best friends, though. You don't like Billy Ocean? Pete Jr. Jr.? He's ignoring me now. I guess he doesn't like Billy Ocean. I don't know. You know? Mike is doing sleep streams. Oh my God. Well, I'm sure it's a snooze fest even when he's awake. What's up, Tiger Nation? I do think we make the playoffs. I have Clemson going 12-1, 11-1, regular season, ACC champion. Most likely if they're 11-1 or 12-1, they're gonna get the playoff. No, we're not going back in. I don't know how many times I got to tell you that. You're stuck with me. I am probably about to go down to the beach, though. I haven't been down there yet. They got jet skis for rent. They've got, what do you call them thing? Paddle boards? I don't even know. That thing you stand up on? Can you see me on one of those things? A paddle board? Nah. What's they got? Kayaks? What else they got? They got all kinds of shit, but I'm not doing any of it. I'm more of a lounger. I like to sit on the beach and people watch. That's more fun than paddle boarding. You know what I mean? Just watch people. and maybe, you know, get up, when I get hot, I'll just go, you know, take a dip in the ocean real quick. Slot watching. Banana boat. There is like a, so there's a, like, so we're on A1A Beachfront Avenue, which is famous from the Vanilla Ice song. That's actually where we're at. We're on A1A Beachfront Avenue. But anyway, so like one block over, away from the beach, there's a, like a canal. I don't know if it's a canal or some sort of waterway. But anyway, you can go over there and they have these water taxis that'll take you all around the city up to like an hour away. And they'll take you to different bars, different shops, different restaurants, and all that. We might end up doing that. It's like $30 a person, though. I've seen too many videos of these people on these kayaks in the ocean, and then a shark comes up and like knocks them over. I'm not trying to do that. Do it. If I had a GoPro, I'd do it. The only reason I would do it is to get video of it, because it would look ridiculous with me paddleboarding. First of all, I have no balance, so it would be a disaster. All I would do is just keep falling in and then trying to get back up on the thing. It would be. Let's say it costs $30 for an hour to paddleboard. 58 of the 60 minutes that I'm on it is me trying to get back up on it from falling off of it. That's it. What's up, buddy? Go in the water and wash it off. Stop rubbing your eyes. All right, I gotta go. This kid's, now he's crying. So thanks for joining me, guys. I'll be back soon.